Want to know how to survive outspawn in every single arena game with the best loot possible? Well, you're in the right place. What's going on, Fortnite family? Bunch of Crunch Army Season 8 hasn't changed the map up a lot, but there are still many drop spots many players don't know about. This is your motivation guide, taking it to the next level today. We're going to be talking about the top 4 best and most underrated drop spots and how you can use secret strategies to win your games at these spots. Don't go anywhere, guys, as this drop spot guide will help you win all of your offspawn fights, whether you're looking for a drop spot as a solo or just with your teammates. Speaking of which, our question of the day. What was your favorite spot to land in the previous season? Whether it be a big POI to farm kills or a secluded split to secure that placement. Let us know. And ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, let's get this going. All right, guys, so our first drop spot is a great split drop that works amazingly for solos, duels, and trios. The Orchard Split is a split that combines the Orchard, Satellite Station, and a gas station that includes a slurp truck. This split drop is amazing if you want the best loot possible and if you want a high chance of being uncontested. Not only does this split drop allow you to have an average of 6 peppers to carry every time, it also allows your trio to save shields by using the slurp truck right next to the Satellite Station. It also guarantees you loot from 3 supply chests, which always have rare or higher weapons and a lot of shields in them. Due to this being a large split, you need to know all of the strategies and techniques pros use to dominate their off-spawn fights if they're uncontested. You know, whether you're playing solos or a team game mode, this drop spot has a lot of different strategies you can use to win off-spawn. You know, when you're landing here as a solo, we recommend having a high drop and aiming for the Satellite Station. The Satellite Station assures you that you have better loot than everybody landing at the Orchard, and it's also just much faster to rotate from and loot from. You know, along with having better loot, you can also use a naturally placed launch pad to really fly to the slurp truck. Having a high drop is definitely the move when trying to claim the split drop, since you have many escape plans if your opponent is contesting the Satellite Station. For example, you can dip off to the Orchard, head to the slurp truck and loot the gas station and drive to Corning. Or you can just choose to completely split off and loot the spire that takes you to Corning Complex. This spot is absolutely phenomenal for solos, as you can easily end up with 4 to 8 peppers every game, have max shields, and always have the best loot. You know, another crazy thing about this split drop is the vending machines. You will always have a vending machine spawn right at the main market of the Orchard, and also have a mini machine spawn at the gas station. Okay, so now that you know the best strategies to use in solos, you also need to know how to dominate this drop spot in a team game mode. Like solos, you should always aim for the Satellite Station as the start to your loot path. However, in team game modes, you need to always 50-50 the Satellite Station and try to have the best drops and fight together. Claiming the Satellite Station allows you to have much better loot than your opponents and also allows you to catch them off guard. For example, if your opponent lands at the Orchard and they split off to loot faster, you can use the natural launch pad and land on one player as a duo trio. This is going to allow you to easily wipe any team that can test the split, and it gives you legendary loot. Let me ask you this. Are you guys struggling to break free from the open or contender divisions in Fortnite? Well, everybody has the potential to improve, and the best way to push that potential to the max is with a Fortnite coach. Our Fortnite coaches are world-class and are available 24/7 to help you guys improve. So head on over to ProGuides.com with the link in the description to improve at Fortnite today. All right, guys, so our next drop spot is combined with a solo strategy that nobody has ever heard of. Take note of the strategy that we're about to show you guys, all right? As this is going to help you place top 3 in any game you play. The Flopper Island next to Craggy is an insanely underrated solo drop that is almost always uncontested and will give you guys legendary loot no matter how bad your luck is. Since this drop spot has an insane amount of fishing spots, you're really bound to receive really good weapons and have a ton of heals. And this is going to help you guys heal very fast in fights and allow you to deal a ton of damage. This drop spot is also extremely easy to loot and really does not require much practice to master. Alright, so to loot this drop spot efficiently, simply just start off by landing at the main house at the island and head on over to the shed at the other side. Make sure to grab a fishing rod, loot all the chests, and just start fishing. This drop spot has a plethora of fishing spots and is why it is so overpowered. You know, after fishing, you can easily just tank storm and just loot the triple houses, which also usually have a shark spawn, which you can kill to get epic or legendary loot and shields. Not only will you leave with some of the best loot in the game, you're also going to be able to tank storm and get the perfect positioning. You can choose to take a boat through Craggy and fish, or you can take the long route and just go through the satellite base and use an IO card to just drive through Pleasant Park. Both of these routes have a ton of fishing spots and campfires, so you don't have to worry about getting stuck in the storm. All right, guys, so our first and and only new drop spot that you need to land at is the crash site in the middle of Holly Hedges and Weeping Woods. This drop spot has a crazy amount of loot that you can loot very fast using the new streamlines, including two vending machines, a plethora of Noms boxes that you can just get peppers from, and a really OP strategy that you could use to get some kills in team game modes. All right, so we don't recommend landing at this spot for solos due to, you know, being so close to a bunch of small solo drop spots that players rotate from, but it's truly up to you. You can simply choose to land at the previously named logjam as a trio to avoid getting picked off when contested, or just split up and just group up quickly by using the streamlines. After looting up, all right, this drop spot allows you to absolutely destroy the Weeping Woods team, since you're given a lot of mobility to loot faster and be versatile. You can use this to your advantage by catching the Weeping Woods team off guard. All right, so simply loot up and fly over to the spire right outside of Weeping. You and your trio can just hit the spire. While the Weeping Woods team is split up and still looting, you can land right on a player and dominate them in a 3v1. This strategy is gonna help you get a lot of kills in arena and help you claim an enormous area of land that you can choose to loot up or use it to gain better positioning. All right, guys, real quick, make sure to check out Clix's new master course right now, ProGuides.com. We also have pro coaches tailored to help you improve quickly. So click the link below or top right to get started today. All right, guys, so our last but extremely underrated drop spot for any game mode, but especially solos, is Camp COD. So this drop spot is arguably like one of the best drop spots for solo arena, and is also an extremely underrated spot for solo cash cups. Okay, so not only does this drop spot allow players to dominate in team game modes, it's also overpowered if used wisely in solos. This drop spot is perfect for very passive players who choose to play placement over W King. So if that's you, consider making this your main drop spot. Not only does this allow you to have loot from the entire island and all the fishing spots, it isolates you from others when uncontested and gives you a lot of time to tank zone and position yourself perfectly. All right, so to dominate Camp COD, we recommend landing at the metal building in the far right corner of the island, loot the other buildings and do some fishing on the side, and just try your best to keep it moving. Camp COD is the worst spot for players who take a ton of time to loot, as it almost never pulls the zone. So make sure you fish and always carry floppers, just in case you have to take a storm fight. All right, so now that this island also has a reboot van, it's just much more beneficial to claim it in team game modes as well. All right, guys, so to recap this video, make sure you practice all the drop spots you've chosen and try your best to consistently win. You know, no matter what, man, using these drop spots in arena will guarantee you success after utilizing pro guides and practicing. So make sure that you put in that time, man. Make sure that you use pro guides to hit your fullest capability, and check out our coaches and other videos that's going to help provide you with the best tips and tricks to winning off spawn and to mastering your drop spot. Speaking of which, you can always check out the rest of our channel for more tips and tricks. And if you guys found this video helpful, you guys already know what to do, because this is your motivation guide. The one is cheering for you to the very end, man. Keep going. Don't be discouraged. I know life gets tough sometimes and we go through a lot of trials and tribulations, but you know what? I learned that if you can make it through each trial, you come out the other side stronger and better. And so that's what's going to happen for you. You're going to come out of this stronger and better, no matter what you're facing. All right, guys, I'll see you on the next one. Peace.